to Skyrim with your host, me, Mario, baby, and 13. Woohoo! But anyways, we got our good friend Lydia over here with our elephant helmet. What's up, Lydia?
Hey, what's up, dude? I miss you so much!
Well, I miss you too, Lydia. Alright, let's go ahead and get straight to it. If right now we just got done taking care of that big giant dungeon thing. Which I should definitely come back down there at some point. Once I get myself strong enough, I should be able to head back down there and gather up as much crimson. I think I remember it was crimson nerd root I need to get when I'm down there anyway, which I will do. And as for this quest, I'm gonna head over to Solstheim when I get myself stronger as well. But right now, we are here at gonna go to the throat of the world. Okay, so let's go. Okay, time for us to send
you have Alvin. It. The Kel, the Elder Scroll. Tidkrech Kalos. Time shudders at its touch. There is no question. You are doom-driven. Kolgan Akatosh. The very bones of the Earth are at your disposal. Go then. Fulfill your destiny. Take the scroll to the Time Wound.
Okay, to the Time Wound we go. We get that giant ammo ready there. Okay, so let's see here. I think. Here we go. Okay, E.
Do not delay. Alduin will.
Alright, Alduin will be here, and I am so ready. I got myself a new. I upgraded my sword from a fine to a superior brand.
Gormley!
Whoa, that's just a
today,
dragon.
Today, Alduin's lordship will be restored. But I honor your courage, Creepwolf Akrin. Die now in vain.
What's going on?
Come on, dude, get him! Way to go!
Hakon! A glorious day, is it not?
Have you no thought beyond the blooding of your blade?
What else is there?
Battle below goes ill. If Alduin does not rise to our challenge, I fear all may be lost.
You worry too much, brother.
Uh-oh.
Victory will be ours!
I think he is here.
Why does Alduin hang back? We've staked everything on this plan.
He will come. He cannot ignore our defiance.
Hell yeah,
why
he will.
Why should he fear us, even now?
We blooded him well. Four of his kin have fallen to my blade alone.
But none have yet stood against Alduin himself. Golfor, Sori, Birko.
They did not have Dragonrend. Once
ooh.
We bring him down, I promise I will have his head.
You do not understand. Alduin cannot be slain like a lesser dragon. He is beyond our strength. Which is why I brought the Elder Scroll.
Feldir, we agreed not to use it.
I never agreed. And if you are right,
help me deal with Alduin ourselves. Here and now.
We shall see soon enough.
Here we go.
Alduin approaches.
So be it.
There he is. That motherfucker.
Me. Tardis. On me. Him Palif. Zu'u Hindan.
Let those that watch from the Southern Guard envy us this day.
Go on.
Look at them. We have learned dragon breath.
First,
streak here.
Skyrim will be free.
That is true. It will be free. Whoa. She has been eaten.
It's no use.
Whoa. That fire is definitely tough.
On the wing. Sister Hawk, grant us a sacred breath to make this contract heard. Be gone, world eater. My words with older bones than your own. We break your perch on this age and send you out. You are banished.
Whoa, Genna, for the win!
From all our endings until the last. You are banished!
Forget he's banished, but not entirely banished.
Did it?
Yes, the World Eater is gone. May the spirits have mercy on our souls.
Okay, it's showtime. Come on out, you pricker. Hey, come on. Okay, time to get prepared. Okay, I think I got Lydia with me, but oh no. No, Lydia, I need you to go.
I've got your back.
I just need you to part ways right now.
I'll head back home if you need me. What was that?
Yeah, just go. Oh man, I should have left Lydia back there. At Whiterun, just for right now. It's just right now. I really don't want her to get killed by Alduin. You know, because there was a one time in the background that I actually end up accidentally killing her. I mean, killing Lydia with a dragon shout of the fire breath on the, well, you know, the oil and flame thing. You know what I mean? Okay, but anyways, let's go ahead and get Dragon Ren up. Okay. Okay, come on over here, you motherfucker!
Lost Fult, you are too late, Alduin!
Haha!
Uh-huh. Use Dragonrend if you know it!
Okay, time for me to equip... Let's see here, got to equip Dragonbane. Okay, we got that equipped, and I think we got it. Oh, great, not that much of a charge, but... It'll do. Matter of fact, I'm gonna use this right now, then at the last minute, I'll go ahead and switch to this. Matter of fact, yeah, this.
Sulaki Murak, Parthrax, my power has waxed.
What waxed? Is this? Okay. Okay, come on. I know, trying to. Trying to get a clear shot of him. He just keeps on moving. Come on. Just stay still just for a second. Just for 1 second, please. Okay, come on. Come on. Trying to get it into good aim. Oh. Hey, come on. Come on. Just stand still for a second, please. I'm not that good when it comes to my aim. Okay, come on. Yeah. Oh, I missed. Did I get him? I'm trying to. Luckily, I got plenty of healing potions for just in case of the occasion. Okay, come on. Okay, that must be Parthenax. Okay. Where in the world is Alduin? I mean, I can't see it all this stuff. Well, at least I think I can. Alright, where did he go? There he is. No, that's Parthenax right over there. That must be Alduin right there. Yep, that's him. Okay, come on. Come on, you frigger. Try to stand still for a second. Now. Gotcha! Come on, you fricker! Land! Right now! Mother fricker! Here I come for your book! Okay. If that does it, dragon bane it. I like it. This is gonna hurt you more than it will hurt me, Alduin. Okay. Try to look for some quick silver ingots before starting this fight so I can upgrade this here weapon to superior. Uh-oh. Got it. Lydia! Oh man, I should have left Lydia back at Whiterun for just the occasion if Alduin ends up killing her. Except I can't, I don't know if I can actually revive her back. There we go, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Maybe I should get some more charged up gems. Okay. Come on, Cracker. Show yourself. Look at that. You got dragon blood. You can look like you're wearing... Okay, come on. Where did you kill Alduin? Okay, there you are. Just give me a sec. Just hold still for a sec while I come ahead and aim for you. Come on, please. Please. You're making me look like a fool up front in front of my subscribers. That's not cool. I will not let you do that. Gotcha. Hopefully I got the right guy. Yes, I did. Okay, that is a deep good. I think I really want to kill Parthenax. Not yet, anyway. Where did he go? Where did he go? I am to a match. Gotcha again. Haha. I know. Weapon recharge. Oop. Okay, luckily I see my health right now. I can push and feel it. There. And there. Come on, you fucker! Oh, great. Okay, luckily I really did have plenty of potions, so I am good. There we go. Man, this guy really does hit hard. Man, okay. Use minor potions of healing. There we go. Okay, healing time again. Luckily, I did in fact have plenty of healing potions. There we go. No, Lydia! Okay, maybe next time I will carry Lydia all around, because seriously, she was definitely a badass when going up against Alduin.
Where are you?
Come on, Lydia, I need to talk to you.
What do you need, my thane?
Okay, follow me, I need your help.
Lead the way.
Okay, once I thought it was a bad idea to have Lydia here with me, but I ended up...
Lot Kongrach. You truly have the voice of a Dovah. Alduin's allies will think twice after this victory.
Freak, yeah. It wasn't really a victory since Alduin escaped.
Nilivrach in Moro. True, this is not the final Krongrach victory. But not even the heroes of old were able to defeat Alduin in open battle.
Freak,
Alduin
yeah.
Always was Pachlok, arrogant in his power. Uznagar Par. He took domination as his birthright. This should shake the loyalty of the Dove who serve him.
I need to find out where Albumine
went. Yes, one of his allies could tell us. Mahus. But it will not be so easy to convince one of them to betray him. Perhaps the Hafkasayun, the palace in Whiterun, Dragon's Reach. It was originally built to house a captive Dova. A fine place to trap one of Alduin's allies, hmm?
Freak, yeah. The Jarl of Whiterun might not think so.
Hmm, yes. But your Sum is strong. I do not doubt that you can convince him of the need.
Okay. You're the master of the Greybeards. Others come here to train? Our Dragon's Reach was built to hold a dragon?
Yes. This was ages ago, you understand. There were more of us then. Before the Bruniki, the Akaviri came and killed all my Zema.
Yeah.
I used to visit him from time to time, nearly crazed by loneliness and captivity. Tiraz Sivaz. He did not even remember his own name. I do not know how he came to be caught, but the Bronyun, the Jarl, was very proud of his pet, Pak. The Hafkasayun has been known as Dragon's Reach ever since.
Okay.
Look, Thum.
Alright, so it looks like we gotta head on over to Whiterun. Man, was that a pretty epic battle.
I've got your back.
Okay, everything's good.
Let's get going then.
Okay, Lydia, you should be still to be good. Yeah, okay. Okay, we're good. Totally good. Alright, let's go. Alright, so let's see here. We gotta head on back on over to Whiterun. To Dragon's Reach. Alright. Oh, look at that. Nearly there to level 11. And I managed to F up Alduin so hard that he will end up being in wherever he needs to go forever.
Cause trouble in Whiterun, and I'll haul you into the Dragon's Reach dungeon myself. You look tired, friend. The Bannered Mare has bent for it.
Oh, I do look tired. I mean, seriously, have you ever battled Alduin before in open combat all by yourself? Well, except for your very cool but very awesome sidekick, Lydia. No, I don't think so, because you don't have a Lydia.
May the gods watch over your battles, friend.
I need your help. I need to trap a dragon in your palace.
I must have misheard you. I thought you asked me to help you trap a dragon in my palace.
You know I would have asked if it wasn't important.
I'm sorry, but I can't do it. We'll just have to keep fighting the dragons as best we can. What you're asking for is insane. Impossible. You want me to let a dragon into the heart of my city, with the threat of war on my doorstep?
It's the only way to stop the dragon attack.
There must be another way. The risk is too great.
The threat is worse than you knew. Alduin has returned.
Alduin? The world-eater himself? But how can we fight him? Doesn't his return mean it's the end times?
It's only hopeless if we give up.
I didn't say anything about giving up. Now what's this nonsense about trapping a dragon in my palace?
It's the only way to find Alduin before it's too late.
I want to help you, Dragonborn. And I will. But I need your help first. Ulfric and General Tullius are both just waiting for me to make a wrong move. Do you think they will sit idle while a dragon is slaughtering my men and burning my city? No. I can't risk weakening the city while we are under the threat of enemy attack. I'm sorry.
What if you didn't have to worry about an enemy attack?
Then I would be glad to help you with your mad dragon-trapping scheme, but getting both sides to agree to a truce will be difficult at this point. The bitterness has gone too deep. Maybe. What of the Greybeards? They are respected by all Nords. High Hrothgar is neutral territory. If the Greybeards were willing to host a peace council, then maybe Ulfric and Tullius would have to listen.
Okay, and leave that to me. I'll talk to Arngeir about hosting a peace council.
Aye, Dragonborn. Maybe you can stop the dragons and this war into the bargain.
Freak yeah. Alright, let's go.
Now, if you don't, I've got a city to keep.
Alright, let's go. So it looks like we gotta head on over to both Solitude and Windhelm. So I can go ahead and help out with stopping the Civil War. For a while, that is, until the dragons are gone. Yeah. Okay, let's go. We gotta head on over to the map. Okay, we gotta head on over to... Oh, we gotta head on over to High Hrothgar first to let them know that we're gonna hold up a peace conference right in there. And it'll be awesome. My powers of persuasion will definitely be the envy of all of Skyrim. Because my powers of persuasion even beats that of all of my subscribers. Not just kidding. You all have better powers of persuasion than me. Because you all are indeed more awesome than myself.
Baldwin? We heard the Dragon Wren shout from here. You defeated him?
Yeah, but he escaped. I need to find this port of the Zavagar.
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle.
I need your help. I need to capture a dragon.
We are not warriors. What is overlooked in the Dragonborn is not permitted to any other followers of the Way of the Voice.
I'll worry about capturing a dragon. I need your help to stop the war.
You misunderstand our authority. The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
Your Balgriff won't help me while the war rages.
The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help.
Both sides respect the Greybeards. They will listen.
Partanax has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk. Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems. So be it. Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to them. We will see if they still remember us.
All right. All right, let's go.
Love. Voice.
Okay, let's go. Alright. So let's see here. We're gonna head on to both Solitude and Whiterun. I mean, Windhelm, not Whiterun. Well, I'm definitely gonna have to go by there anyway. Okay, let's go.
Being old's not so bad. Daughter keeps me fed.
I'm not interested, Jari. It doesn't matter how many times you ask.
Okay,
how about I trade you a song?
You might want to rethink that.
You don't.
You're missing out. It's wonderful.
What? The queue must have plenty of bales to tell.
Oh, I do.
Got to keep my eyes.
Gotta keep my eyes open. Damn dragons can become at any time.
Are my men now giving free rein to anyone who wanders into the castle? Do you have some reason to be here, citizen?
I believe we have already met.
Have we? Oh, of course. You were at Helgen.
Yes, that's right.
One of the prisoners, if I recall correctly.
I helped Hadvar, and he said he vouched for me.
Hadvar's alive? I hope that's true. He's a damn good soldier. But he hasn't reported in yet, so he can't exactly confirm your story. In the meantime, why don't you have a chat with Legate Ricca? I suspect we might have use for someone resort. Besides, I'm sure your being imprisoned was
I'm telling you, Ulfric is planning an attack.
Speak with Legate Rikka. She will determine if you are Legion material.
I have a message from the Greybeards.
The Greybeards? What do those old hermits want with me?
They are convening a peace council at High Hrothgar.
Why, there's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor.
Well, we need a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
They are getting to be a problem. But I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that, dragons or no dragons.
Okay, the dragons are a bigger problem than the Stormcloaks right now.
I'll be the judge of that. Besides, by all reports, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as much as we are from these dragon attacks.
The best time to negotiate is from a position of strength. Let's see here.
Fair enough. We're driving the Stormcloaks back well enough at the moment, but we're already overstretched. That's what comes of trying to win a war with a bare handful of legions. If the Emperor would just give me the reinforcements I've requested.
Why won't the Emperor say more reinforcements?
Most of the Legion is tied down on the border with the Aldmeri Dominion. The Emperor can't afford to risk weakening Cyrodiil's defenses. From the Imperial City, our war here is just a sideshow. An interlude before the main event against the Thalmor resumes.
You'll come to the Peace Council then?
Yes. Yes, fine. I'll come to this Greybeard Council. For all the good it will do.
He'd be insane to try. He doesn't have the men.
That's not what my scouts report, sir. Every day more join his cause. Riften, Dawnstar, and Winterhold...
Okay, Pelagius.
How can I help a brother Nord?
Okay. Alt, let's see here. Oh, map. M for map. Okay. Now they're gonna head on over to Whiterun. I mean, not Whiterun, but Windhelm. Oh, I did not place the marker on that yet. No. Okay, head on over to the stables of Windhelm. Orcs, also known as Orzammer, are natives to Orzinium, a small mountain kingdom between Hammerfell and Skyrim. It has been sacked for many years.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something in the old fort.
Oh yeah, we're gonna go after vampires too. It's gonna be awesome.
You eat our food, you pollute our city with your stink, and you refuse to help the Stormcloaks.
I'm a Northwind.
Man,
laying over in Windhelm.
This must be the capital of Skyrim. Or I think it is. Or, matter of fact, I think this is the oldest city in Skyrim.
Spare a coin for a poor old woman.
I'll go ahead and spare a coin, but
the
just give me a
second. Dragons breathing fire in the sky? Vampires bracing the attacking... It's no
secret
the Aretino boy is doing some rituals.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
Don't be so sure of that.
I remember you. You're in Helgen with us. Come to join the war. Speak with Garmar. He handles the new recruits.
That's not why
I'm sorry to hear that. If you change your mind, speak with Garmar. What does bring you to me?
I have a message for the Greybeards.
It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want?
They want to negotiate a truce until the dragon menace is dealt
with. I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this. Unless Tullius himself will be there.
Politics be damned, Alduin has returned.
Alduin, the world eater of song and legend. If that's true, we're all doomed anyway. And if it isn't true, well, then the fight to free Skyrim goes on. Either way, I don't see the use in talking to the Empire.
The Greybeards won't let the Empire take advantage of
you. You speak truly, Dragonborn. Sometimes the grubby business of politics clouds my eyes. Besides, it will be good to see High Hrothgar again.
So you'll come to the Peace Council?
Yes. I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs.
Okay.
What would you have me do?
If he's not with us,
Stormcloaks are finding victory across the land.
He knows that. They all know that.
How long are you going to wait?
You think I need to send Borgruff a stronger message?
If by message you mean shoving a sword through his gullet.
Taking his city and leaving him in disgrace would make a more powerful statement, don't you think?
So we're ready to start this war in earnest, then?
Soon.
Alright, so it looks like we got both General Tullius and... Is it General Tullius and... Ulfric to join the Peace Council.
Spare a coin for an old woman? Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
There you go. I gave you a coin, just like I said. Charitable soul. Alright, so let's see here. We got to head on over to High Hrothgar. Here we go, to High Hrothgar, baby. We're gonna go ahead and host up the Peace Council. Okay, rabbits are a common sight in the tundra of Skyrim. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and save it from here. That way, in case I make a mistake, or in case I can actually see if there's a difference between the way I do things. You know what I mean. In case I mess up and stuff. Because I'm dealing with the future of Skyrim over here, people.
So, you've done it. Men of violence are gathered here, in these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have agreed to host this council. Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters.
Don't worry, I'll get them to agree. Peace.
Peace? I doubt it. They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength for the next bloodletting. They are not yet tired of war. Far from it. You know the ancient Nord word for war? Season unending. So it has proved. But regrets are pointless. Here we are. Take your seat at the council table.
Okay.
Let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim.
Alright. Let's go ahead and take our seat. There's Delphine.
So, Arngeir, is it? You know why we're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
You're not invited here. You're not welcome here.
We have as much right to be at this council as all of you. More, actually, since we were the ones that put the Dragonborn on this path.
Were you?
Oh, really?
The use of the blades truly knows no bounds.
Delphine, we're not here to rehearse old grudges. The matter at hand is urgent. Alduin must be stopped. You wouldn't have called this council if you didn't agree. We know a great deal about the situation and the threat that Alduin poses to us all. You need us here if you want this council to succeed.
Very well. You may enter.
They better not. Delphine and this other guy, Esbern, will not dare to F up this council. I will take my seat. Excuse me, coming through. I am here to take your seat. Okay, I am here to sit in my seat. I'm sorry, Lydia, but you're gonna have to stand up, and I know your feet must have been aching from wearing those steel boots all this time. I am here to take my seat. Looks like we get the Thalmor over there, which I won't come back to the Thalmor embassy and give them a bashing of a lifetime. But just for right now, I think everyone will be good.
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin.
Okay, take your seats, everyone.
I hope that we have all come here in the spirit.
You insult us by bringing her to this negotiation. your ship, Talos Hunter?
That didn't take long.
Here.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please, if we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere.
Perhaps yeah, you're telling
I'm
here.
Good time to get the Dragonborn's input on this matter.
By Ysmir's beard. The nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? To think that I would sit down at the same table with that Thalmor bitch. Either she walks or I do.
Oh, what's the harm? Besides, Tullius doesn't really want her here either.
Maybe so, but bringing her here is a deliberate provocation. Tullius needs to know I won't be pushed around.
I agree. This will set the tone for the whole negotiation. Elwyn should go, because the Empire should be the one who is going to decide things, not the Dalmor. So I agree that Elwyn should go.
Well said.
Very well, Ulfric. Enjoy your petty victory. The Thalmor will treat with whatever government rules Skyrim. We would not think of interfering in your civil war.
Ha! Skyrim will never bow to the Thalmor. Unlike your Imperial friends here.
You're lucky I respect the Greybeard's council, Galmar.
Legate, we represent the Emperor here.
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't be able to resist.
We're here to arrange a temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
I want a drink.
Yes, let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed?
Yes.
Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, this council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar, and do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace. Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes, let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here,
Markarth?
You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif.
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect something for nothing.
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
What do I want in return?
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that... traitor!
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough! First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth.
Okay. Riften, no. I am definitely going to keep that person in Riften. I am not in favor of having Maven Blackbriar to be in charge of... that's it. I'm not going to have Maven Blackbriar to be in charge of Riften. So I am going to say Winterhold seems like a fair trade. Yeah, definitely Winterhold.
in exchange for Markarth, the source of most of Skyrim silver.
Hardly.
Riften seems like a better choice to me. Well fortified, easily resupplied from across Lake Honrik. Plus all the mead we can drink.
Okay. There is advantages in taking Winterhold. Persuade.
Not enough to outweigh the loss of Markarth. With the Reach in enemy hands, our whole position in Solitude would be threatened.
You asked for my opinion, and so I gave it to you. Let's see, Riften. You asked for my opinion,
Fair
so I
enough.
Gave it to you.
I was hoping you could put aside your loyalties for the greater good, but I see you're firmly in Ulfric's camp. Still, Winterhold would allow us to directly threaten the rebel supply lines out of Windhelm. Better than nothing, I suppose. But Ulfric will need to offer a lot more if he wants me to give up Markarth without a fight.
The Dragonborn has spoken, Tullius. Markarth will be ours. Now we'll see if there's anything behind your talk of good faith.
You disappoint me, Dragonborn. I accepted your invitation on trust in your good name. But it seems you intend to favor Ulfric.
I do not favor Ulfric.
I can see now that this is not a negotiation at all. I know you, Ulfric. If I hand over Markarth, you'll be ready with a new demand. You'll never defeat the Empire, and you know it. You're willing to sacrifice thousands for your own selfish ambition. Soon enough, I'll have you back under the headsman's axe, and this time there won't be any dragon to save you.
As always, the Empire's fine words are worth nothing.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Delphine? If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me, and I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
I don't know about the end of the world, but this dragon situation has gotten out of hand. If this truce will help the Dragonborn here put an end to that menace, we both gain. Remember that, Ulfric. Now, back to the matter at hand.
All right.
You know as well as I do that we can't hand over Markarth on these terms.
You see what talking to them gets us.
Let's hear it.
We want compensation for the massacre at Karthwaisten.
You slaughtered the very people you claim to be fighting for. True sons of Skyrim would never do such things.
Damned Imperial lies. My men would never stoop to such methods, even in retaliation for your butchery at...
All the blood spilled in this war is on your head.
So, Dragonborn, what do you say?
Well, let's see here. I got one thing from Ulfric, so I think I'm gonna go side with Imperials. That way, I do not seem like if I'm being one-sided because I'm the Dragonborn. I need to be neutral. So that means that I give 1 point to Ulfric. So that means I should give 1 point to the Empire. So I say that Ulfric should compensate you for Karthwaisten.
Well said. For once, you'll actually pay for your crimes. You know I can't agree to these terms. The Emperor would repudiate this treaty, and I would be recalled.
Damn Imperial arrogance.
Let's hear it.
We want the Pale returned to Imperial control. The traitor Skald the Elder will be replaced with a more loyal candidate.
What next, Tullius? Shall I just hand over all of Skyrim?
I guess I have no choice but to let the Dragonborn decide, although I'm starting to doubt your fairness.
Yeah.
So, Dragonborn, what do you say?
Okay, let's see here. Ulfric doesn't need to give up any more territory. Huh. Okay, this thing is gonna be a tough one. The Pale. I gotta think here. Well, they have Winterhold. And... The Pale. Yeah, the Pale.
I knew I could count on you. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement. Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces, Jarl Igmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. Ulfric will allow Imperial troops to enter Winterhold. Corrier will replace Kraldar as Jarl. The Stormcloaks will pay appropriate compensation for the massacre at Carthwaistel. The Pale will be turned over to the Empire. Brynna Merilis will assume the Jarlship in Dawnstar. You both agree to this?
The Sons of Skyrim will live up to their agreements, as long as the Imperials hold to theirs.
Hell yeah, we did it!
What about you, Elisif? Are these terms to your liking? Speak up! I'm sure General Tullius is waiting to do your bidding.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
Come on, Dalmar.
We have much work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this truce, Dragonborn. I hope it was worth it.
Jarl Balgruuf. I assume you are familiar with the Dragonborn's plan.
Yes, I'm ready to do my part. Just say the word, and my men will help you spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains, how to lure a dragon to Dragon's Reach at all?
Well, that's an excellent question. You haven't overlooked that little detail, have you?
Ah, I believe I can be of help here. I anticipated the problem. While you were arranging this meeting, I was busy in the library of Skyhaven Temple, an unguessed trove of lost lore. But the important thing is that the blades recorded many of the names of dragons they slew. Cross-referencing this with Delphine's map of dragon burial sites, I believe I've identified one of the dragons that Alduin has raised up.
How does that help us?
Don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power, shouts. By calling the dragon with a voice, he will hear you wherever he might be.
Okay, and why would he come?
He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful by nature and loath to refuse a challenge. Your voice in particular is likely to intrigue this dragon after your victory over Alduin. I think it's very likely that he will be unable to resist investigating your call.
What's the dragon's name?
Indeed. I'm no master of the voice, like these worthy gentlemen. But it is written here, in this scroll. Odaving, winged snow hunter, as I read it. I will feel that there's
one more question. We know.
I've discovered who the Greybeards are.
Turns out he's a dragon, but he helped me.
That's fine. We needed his help. Now we don't. And it's long past time for him to pay for his crimes. And he's not just any dragon. He was the right hand of Alduin. He committed atrocities so infamous they are still remembered thousands of years later. He needs to die. He deserves to die. And it falls to you to kill him. Until he's dead. I'm sorry, but we would dishonor our oaths as blades if we continue to help you.
Huh. you have against the Greybeards?
If they had their way, you do nothing but sit up on their mountain with them and talk to the sky or whatever it is they do. The Greybeards are so afraid of power that they won't use it. Think about it. Have they tried to stop the Civil War or done anything about Alduin?
Well, they are indeed doing something about Alduin.
They're afraid of you, of your power. Trust me, there is no need to be afraid. Think of Tiber Septim. Do you think he'd have founded the Empire if he'd listened to the Greybeards?
Good point there. Alright, we did it. Lucky we got both sides to agree on something. Hell yeah. Woohoo! Oh yeah, baby. Mead, the Peacekeeper, for the win. But anyways, I hope that y'all had a good time. And we're gonna have a jolly good time. We're gonna be playing some more Skyrim later on. Tomorrow, I think. It's gonna be awesome. And you'll have a nice day now. And I hope to catch you all later. Take care now. Hey, I'm Gear. I mean, hello, Inarit. How many Dragon Bars does it take to screw with Alduin?
I don't know. Not much.
Well, I would have to choose one, which is me. Only I can screw with Alduin.